Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. At the end of the last episode, we completed all the drowned trucks task and reached rank 7, which means we've unlocked the mud tires for our scout vehicles. The Chevy is back in Island Lake, where we left it after repairing the Western Star twin steer, so let's head back there and complete some more tasks before bringing it back to the garage. Not far from where we'd parked is the 5.0 engine upgrade for the scouts. Like the 5.2, the high fuel consumption makes this a tough sell for hard mode. There are some engine upgrades for trucks where the trade-off of torque versus fuel consumption is worthwhile, but for a lot of the scout vehicles like the Chevy, we tend to see them lose traction far more often than we see the engine stalling out due to a lack of torque. There is a fuel semi-trailer not far from the Smithville Dam gateway, which we can fill up from. At a later stage, I'll likely move this trailer to a more convenient location. There is a nearby watchtower we can discover, and then we can head towards the lumber mill to find the engageable diff upgrade for the White Western Star. The start of the path we need to take is difficult to spot if approaching from this direction. Just look for the gap in the trees with the rocks, then take a left. While we're in this part of the map with the scout vehicle, we can complete the task, A Little Help for My Friends. Heading down the hill, there is a watchtower we can discover along the way. After discovering the first two waypoints, it's worthwhile backtracking slightly down this road to pick up the signal in the mountain's task. At the crossroads, if we take a left, we can discover a scout fuel carrier, which will be very useful later on. I'll leave the scout fuel trailer at the intersection for now and continue on with a little help for my friend's mission. With that complete, we can head to the checkpoint for the signal in the mountains task. Reaching the checkpoint allows us to start the broken antenna task. Continuing on over the hill will take us to the final watchtower, which we need to discover on Island Lake. The autonomous winch proved its worth again here, as we're about as far as we could possibly be from the nearest vehicle we could use to recover the Chevy. This turns what would have been a major rescue operation into a non-event. There is a gap in the rocks just wide enough for the Chevy, which we can use as a shortcut to get back to the main road. Back at the crossroads, let's take a left and discover the corporate expansion task and pick up the final upgrade on this map. This is really only worth picking up to get the achievement for finding all the upgrades in Michigan, as the engine can only be used in the Ford CLT 9000, which is in the same class as the International Transtar, so the chances of us ever using it are incredibly low. Back at the crossroad, let's pick up the scout fuel carrier and make our way back to Smithville Dam. Top up the Chevy and the carrier from the fuel semi-trailer. The scout fuel carrier will be useful later on for a mission to repair and refuel a GMC 9500, which isn't far from here, so I'll leave it and head on to discover the nearby watchtower. Heading north along this path, we can pick up the engageable diff lock upgrade for the GMC 9500 and discover another watchtower. With those discovered, let's head back to the garage. The mud tyres aren't actually a massive upgrade over the off-road tyres in muddy conditions, and on the paved roads they tend to make the Scouts wander quite a bit, but they do make just enough of an improvement overall to be worthwhile. Just past the farm, there is a path to the right which will lead us to the next watchtower. Thank you. Next, let's get the engine upgrade for the International Transtar I mentioned in a previous episode. We can sell this upgrade and also sell the Transtar when we're next back at the garage. For now though, let's head towards the drilling site where we can pick up a mission and then discover the final watchtower on the Smithville Dam map. With the final watchtower discovered, it's worth continuing along this path to pick up the solid foundation task, as this will drop a concrete slab we can use for this mission back at the drill site, saving us from having to pick it up at one of the warehouses. Thank you. On our way back, we can discover another trailer with metal beams at the logistics base, and then pick up the well mission just past the logging station. Heading back through the farm, we can pick up the final upgrade on the Smithville dam map, the 4.4 engine upgrade for the scout vehicles. We've now discovered all the watchtowers and upgrades on the Island Lake and the Smithville Dam map, so I'll leave it there for this episode. Thanks for watching.